Program Director, thank you very much. You know, this is a very difficult task, to introduce the DM. The DM doesn't like really to give a huge profile. She says, you know what, this is, these are matters of public choice. So, this is a difficult task, which means that I'm going to be a bit violent DM and just touch few things that our DM, we call her Umamawe Nation. She is right there in the thick of things to make sure that the cooperatives are developed. I tell you, ladies and gentlemen, if I could use my own personal experience, the DM always is here on my neck. Make sure that cooperatives are developed. I don't have any room to breathe. I know that under her, there will be no escape. The work will happen. DM, really, in your environmenting, your request, let me just touch two things. The DM is with a long history being involved in struggle. She also comes from a union background, very rich background, where she participated in ensuring that our workers enjoy the rights that today we take it for granted, to have unions that are well mobilized, that articulate the rights of the working workers here in our country. She comes from that background. She has also seat on various portfolio committees in government, both in the trade and industry portfolio committee. She has also been our deputy minister twice, ladies and gentlemen. So with those, let's give a round of applause and welcome our DM to address us this evening, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you. DM, the podium is yours now.
Mr. Wellings Maseko, including your executives. I think all of them are here, since all the secretaries and your treasurers, etc. Director of the International Labour Organization Country and Office in South Africa, Mr. Vic Van Furen, representative of the South African United Nations International Day of Co-operatives, Coordination Committee, Ms. Mandla Gala Gatani, honorable colleagues, co-operators, friends, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the observed, and good evening. Good evening. How's the evening treating you so far? Okay, program directors have got about 6 page speech here, but I'll try and be very short, I'm sure. The keynote address at the gala dinner, I think, is not appropriate. It's better to do remarks, not keynote address, because it's late at night, and I'm sure the MSC would agree with me. Just cut and make remarks rather than he did quite well, I think. But firstly, I would like to really thank the leadership of the province, whether government or ANC-led, but in particular the MEC President of Economic Development. I think it is fulfilling to see such a venue and name after one of our veterans, namely this Berebere. It is indeed a good investment for the country and for the province. This is a really good venue that I think we took the right decision, I think, to build this convention center. And I'm sure we'll see much more economic activities in the MEA and other related functions. But to me, it's really, really, really fulfilling today to be in this facility. I hope we'll never forget the contribution made by Nemi Kastarabere as one of our stalwarts and veterans of the movement. And she contributed quite a great deal to our freedom. It is upon their shoulders that here today we are enjoying this freedom. And I think this dinner also takes place during the 8th month, but you're not here to talk about June 16 only, but to make sure that you can remember the efforts made by the youth in 1976 and the current youth of today. And it gives me the pleasure to be standing here and make sure that I can again this year talk to you during the gala dinner. Last year we were in the Eastern Cape. Is it Eastern Niger? Where were we yesterday? East London? Huh? Yeah, in East London. We hosted the same function and it was really good, I think, to be back with the co-operators again. Many of us, I think, here tonight have traveled this developmental path together for the past 10 years and have experienced successes, challenges, and also learned some valuable lessons from our mistakes. But where we go to from here in the next 10 years, I think it is a direction we need to determine together as government, cooperative movement, the business community, and organized labor. Recommendation 193 clearly spells out each and every constituent role, and we need to refocus our attention to ensure that in the coming 10 years, the cooperative movement that are promoted and supported become sustainable enterprises that can play a much more meaningful role in our economy. And in so doing, impact positively on the lives of the members of the surrounding community in which they operate. And tomorrow morning, cooperatives will get an opportunity to showcase the successes that have achieved over the years. However, I think I want to encourage all of them that it should not be only the first Saturday in July to showcase these successes, but it must be ongoing. And with the available opportunity, please do so. I also urge cooperatives to take ownership of their own marketing, so that cooperatives become a lot more visible, not only at meetings or conferences or co-ops initiatives, but in everyday lives. Put up visible signs, hand out business cards, information brochures about your business. You're missing out on the marketing platform offered by word of mouth. Travel is very fast and you can reach many people. But I want to share with you something I mentioned in the speech at the function that was hosted for the International Co-operatives Alliance, that cooperatives constitute a significant part of the global economy, and that you have learned that according to your global 300 mechanism, the top 20 cooperatives around the world had nearly $1 trillion in revenues as far as 2007. In fact, at the meeting, I was advised that this number now stands at $1.6 trillion by the president of the alliance. And we need that work towards ensuring that the cooperatives in South Africa start making a meaningful contribution to the country's GDP. It is possible if this can happen elsewhere in the globe, why not us in South Africa? But I also want to mention something else I spoke about, that overall cooperatives create over 100 million jobs in the whole world. More than all of the multinational corporations combined, also as far back as 2007. As you can see, it is a well-documented fact that cooperatives can play a meaningful role in job creation and the reduction of poverty and also inequality. I don't want to go into too much detail about the economic aspect of cooperation and cooperatives, but I think we leave that for the Honourable Minister tomorrow, Dr. Davis, to share with you in the celebrations tomorrow, as we normally share activities with him. But overall, if he was here, he was going to be the speaker, Jeff. I was not going to be the speaker, I was going to support him, because I don't believe that we have to compete with the minister. We assist the minister to make sure that he can see his outcome for, and make sure that he can create jobs and give people. In fact, I can sleep at home and the whole year and not wake up and just say present one day and come up outside living with the president. It's only the minister. But I believe in a team spirit that we must be able to achieve that, and that's why if he was here, he was going to be the speaker. What I want to do tonight is to emphasize the necessity to markets and showcase and celebrate the successes of cooperative businesses in itself. It has a meaningful role to play in ensuring that cooperatives are recognized on the economic playing field as a key business entity to contend with. But of course, as cooperatives use platforms such as these and other marketing platforms that are available, they are able to raise the profile of cooperatives within the business communities. We also need to move cooperatives beyond just subsistence level forms of business to viable and successful business entities that engage deeply in all sectors of the economy and are able to operate on the same economic playing field as other business forms. I listened attentively to the representatives of the UN when she reported about today's activity. And the chief director briefly just told me that it's very successful meeting. I didn't ask the details, but thanks for the details, and I hope you'll be able then to make to what you reported, because I would like to see then some implementation of what you were saying here. It was not only for us, TTI, to make sure that cooperatives can be a very viable tool, sustainable. I think the partnership works much more better, because we provide what we can provide as TTI. Facilities, access to markets, take you to exhibitions, take you to where you can go and sell. But even CIS, the incentives, but at the end of the day, it is the cooperators themselves who will be able to take forward and make sure that the sustainability seed is planted. Otherwise, then it will be all in vain. So I was very, very attentive listening to the report. And I'm sure they will be able to see a better implementation of your collective points that you raised. But thank you once more. Because this will then promote and make sure that we have a viable autonomous cooperative movement. In addition to ensuring that we create an environment that is conducive to the creation and support of viable autonomous cooperatives, the Department of Trade and Industry has also been implementing both financial and non-financial support in order to make sure that you can realize these targets and make sure that you can be able then to form working cooperatives. I look forward then to the meeting and engaging with cooperators tonight and tomorrow as we start off celebrations for the weekend. But I also like to end off by thanking all colleagues, stakeholders who are here tonight, in particular the province and the mayors, the two of them, that they are here and have been able to take forward all the efforts that is started with them. In fact, I've been to some of the districts and promoting taking the care to the people. In that, we are also saying that we must come back either a year or two to come and check whether they've implemented what we were talking about, and in particular if they can form cooperatives. So my two mayors, I hope I'll be able them to come and see me. I'm not sure whether this year or next year, because this is a very hectic year. It's already July. If Ms. Maybe we can try and say, let's look before November. If not, then I can come next year. Any next year then to make sure that we can see what happened after we've been there. I hope to get good results and my 2 minutes. Huh?
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, yes, ma'am. That's good. If it's yes, ma'am, then it's fine. I'll be able then to go back there and then make sure that we can deal with these aspects. But also, I think from your side, within either community development province and your local economic development, I'm not sure that those structures still exist at the local level. These will be part of your priorities, I'm sure, so that you can be able to talk to the 5 million jobs. Because at the end, you're promoting those who need to take it to tell the people to your areas. And we hope that we'll be able then to report on those and make sure that you can move. In terms of then the next 10 years, the challenges upon all of us, but in particular, cooperators and private sector buy-in, as well as our agencies, I think they are going to play a critical role. Some of these, I think it's NAF, CIDA. CIDA, I'm sure, is representative, though the CEO is not here. CIDA is here. Oh, yes. Okay. I've not seen the provincial manager, Kidisalet. Is she here? Oh, there she is. But I saw some also from the national office. My dear came to see another, Zandini, who are dealing with the CPPP. Because I think those are the new forms that they're trying to make sure that we can support cooperatives much more and in a better way. We will launch, I think, is it 2 or 3? Zandini. We launched one for the youth in Mpumalanga, where the youth is dealing with the nuts, macadamia nuts, as well as bananas. They bought a farm, and then we are assisting them. As well as the pawpaw, where we also supported a cooperative that is doing the pepper juice and processing the other plant and exporting, also selling to Woodwards. So in this province, I'm not sure what is it that is in for the CPPP, so that we can be able to say, this is what we have done. It can be good during 2012, when the Green Party is celebrating 100 years. But if not, I'm sure 2013 can be also something that we can come and say, what is it that we do here in this province? Surely there's appetite, and there's good cooperation within the government. We've shared a good working relationship with MEC for over years now, and we hope that we'll continue to do that and make sure that we change our people's lives and empower them to be good citizens and deal with unemployment. I think Jeff is enough. It's dinner. People, it's not good to stand before people and dinner. Some people listen to you if you speak for 5 minutes. They'll just, you know, shut and talk. So please, thanks. I was also worried we're competing with some music. I'm not sure whether it's next door, or is it some building, or whatever, because it was quite high. The noise was quite high. I was not sure whether we're going to migrate to that place, or what. But as you know, I can hear now it is quiet. So thank you very much. Thanks, Jeff. I still maintain, I don't like to introduce with whatever. That's not my style of work. I think also, I took it from the former premier of this province, the Minister of Energy. when I was working here and being a, what were we called that time, political champions. And then now it's John Dowell Hudson, isn't it? Something like that. Yes, I used to work there for 4 years and then I started this thing moreover. Then I heard about second, third people talking about that. I said, yeah, this is the right thing. I just said, which one is not right? Because surely it's more or less like an obituary when people introduce you, where you come from, what you achieve academically, what your life was, where and how. And at the end, I already know already what are people going to say when I'm normal. Why do I listen to it now when I've had it for so many years and I already know in any way? But thank you very much, Chief Director. Keep up the good. I'll be on your leg, please. As much as I'm still at the DTI, I'm deployed there. I will be on your neck whether you like it or not. But I like the spirit. I'm on your neck whatever, but don't take a grudge. Because some officials end up, having a grudge about white issues. But I think Jeff Lung is one of those that appeal. He's one of the best. I fight him on his neck, what? But at the end of the day, we do work as a team. He really understands what is it that I'm driving at, and I hope your peers will be the same, like you, and not really come with unnecessary approaches to the work until we have a strong cooperative movement that is working. Tertiary later. Secondary, but let's make sure that the primary cooperatives are working. And I'm going to take a tour around some of the provinces to check on those cooperatives, because I last did them in 2008-2009. So I must do it again, so that I can go and see how many of those cooperatives are working, if not working, what is the problem? Because I don't believe in the paper report. I believe in going there physically, checking and making sure that as I'm on a platform budget vote. I don't say it, but more than 2,000 cooperatives that we registered, they're all working, only to find that not even 1,000 that are working. Some of them law, some are in ICU. Some are still not coming, they are hospitalized. Some are, so that is, I think, but together, working, all of us, partnerships, we will really do more. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much to Ms. Elizabeth Thabete for that keynote address. I just want to agree with you there for a second. And, if there's anything I know about crowds and audiences, is they respond to food and they respond to freebies. So if you're giving away something free, yeah, you'll have the crowd on your side. All right, ladies and gentlemen, to point out, we are going to have our dinner served in a second. We're going to serve ourselves. It's a buffet. On the left, your right-hand side. Is where you can serve yourself dinner, and on the right hand side, that is reserved for the VIPs, and I'm going to ask the VIPs to please lead us, as a matter of fact, if we could be so courteous as to let them happen. Now, in the radio, which I happen to do as well, they say you always back announce and throw forward and then say what's happening right now. So in other words, allow me for a second. In radio terms, it would mean you say, that was Phil Collins, we're waiting for the night, ne? And you say, still coming, take care of the glass. Right now, here is, what shall I? So using that radio analogy, just want to say, that was Miss Elizabeth Thabete. We're still going to have entertainment, the vote of thanks, DJ action, and SMS. Right now, do you know, sir?